Recently, I was asked, what would I do with some free Azure credits? So the answer for me was pretty simple. I could, one, create an app that would change the world, two, create an app that would make me millions of dollars, or three, create an app that would maximize my recreational time. And of course, I went with number three. So what I did is I mismatched a bunch of different Azure services together to create an app that lets me view movie reviews. So what I did is I used Azure Cosmos DB, I used Azure Functions, and to top that all off, I used Azure AD B2C, and I wrapped it all in a pretty bow using Xamarin to create a mobile app that runs on multiple platforms at once. So let's talk about each of these in pieces. So first off, let's talk about Azure Cosmos DB. Azure Cosmos DB is a multi-model, globally distributed database. What does that mean? Well, the multi-model means you could have multiple different underlying databases to it. You could have a pure DocumentDB SQL database, you could have a MongoDB database, you could have a Cassandra database, many different NoSQL databases underneath it. The globally distributed part means that I could go through and I could say, all right, instead of just having a read region in Seattle, I could create read regions all over the world. That way, no matter where you are, or no matter where I am and I want to see movie reviews, I could enable these and have fast data downloading to my device. Next up are the function apps. So what I'm doing with this function app is that I'm going in and I'm having serverless functions running. And so what serverless means is not only just that there's no servers running, there's servers running, rather that there's no infrastructure for me to set up. I just have some code running and I'm letting Azure take care of everything on the back end for me. And then AD B2C, what is that? Azure Active Directory Business Consumer. It provides a login functionality for me. It allows me to take users and log them in with Twitter or GitHub or a plain old username and password. So let's see the code for this. Let's see how they all interact together so I can use a movie review app. So quick, first off, here's the movie reviews. Log started up and I see different reviews for the movies. I go in and I see for A Star is Born, I have a review date of October 12th and the review is, well, I've seen better, of course. And then I can go in and I don't see any other reviews. So what I'm doing here is I'm holding out premium reviews for people who have logged in using Azure AD B2C. So you got some reviews which are not premium and other reviews which are premium that only are available for people who've logged in. So let's see all the code for this put together. The Cosmos DB code databases is all NoSQL and is sitting up in the cloud. To get at Cosmos DB on the client side, I'm using an SDK, all within, wrapped in within my Xamarin app. And so what this allows me to do is when I load up this document client, it automatically can figure out where I am to give me the closest read region, thus the fastest way to get the data down. Now, you'll notice something here that I'm calling this Cosmos token. So what this allows me to do is not have anything within my app that has a connection string or any username and passwords. Rather, what I'm going out and doing is I'm calling what I say is a function service. So this is getting into my serverless. And this serverless thing goes through here and calls this actual Azure function. Now, this function says a couple different things, but the coolest thing I want to point out is this right here, this attribute that says DocumentDB and specifies a database name and a collection name. So what this is saying here for me is that it automatically ties to the Cosmos DB service for me. So it comes in and ties in this document client variable for me. I don't have to worry about newing up that document client or doing anything else. Azure Functions has a bunch of bindings that do all the hard work for me, which is unbelievable. It takes care of all the thinking for me. And it news it up, it gets rid of it from memory, everything for me. So this is an HTTP trigger. What that means is that it's a normal web responds to gets, responds to posts. And then when it goes out, it does various operations upon the Cosmos DB database. So this, again, using the Cosmos DB SDK, is I'm going on and creating permissions to get at the movie reviews. So the movie reviews are stored in Cosmos, and they look like the following. I just have a ID, a movie ID, and this is premium. So this is premium tells me whether I want to be able to download the review for somebody who's been logged in. The is premium here being false says don't download the review if you're not logged in. All right. So the functions here are giving me permission, giving a permission token. So that tells the client whether you can be downloading or not. Going in then to my authentication or how I actually download. All it is, there's a client, another SDK, and all I'm saying here is acquire token async. And that's all it takes to actually log in and get the movie reviews. So let's actually do that. I'm going to sign in with my social account, with my Twitter. Hit that. It goes out. I've already signed in with Twitter, so you can see that it quickly went redirect me back. And so now I'm going to Google how to train your dragon, and it comes in good stuff, highlighted in red, indicating that this is a premium review. I go back to A Star is Born, not a premium review, so it comes back in black. So now I have this movie review app, which is showing me premium reviews because I've logged in. It's showing me regular reviews, because I don't need to be logged in to see it, but if I'm logged in, I can still do it as well. And so now I've built very quickly and wrapped this all in a Xamarin app, a movie review service using Cosmos DB, using Azure Functions, using Azure AD B2C to provide login functionality for me, and also put this all into a client cross-platform 100% native Xamarin app, which also is free using the community version of Visual Studio or Visual Studio for Mac. So with Azure Cosmos DB, you get 5 gigabytes of database free per month. With Functions, you get up to 1 million calls per month. With Azure AD B2C, you get up to 50,000 users per month. That really quickly is what I would do with my free Azure credits. I would build a recreational app just so I can see movie reviews on the fly, on the go, with Azure and Xamarin. So my name is Matt Sokup, Senior Cloud Developer Advocate here at Microsoft. And if you have any questions at all, any comments at all regarding anything Azure or Xamarin, feel free to reach out for me at CodeMailMatt on Twitter. Thanks a lot. Talk to you soon.